Hello everyone, in this video we are going to learn the first chapter, real numbers. Find HCF by Euclid division lemma, EDL. So the first, the question is 50, 70. Always the bigger number is A and the smaller number is B. So already we know the formula for EDL. A is equals to BQ plus R. Dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So here A is nothing but 70 is equals to B. Divisor is 50 into. Let us do here rough work. 50. I am dividing 70 by 50. 51 is a 50. 20 is the remainder. So the same as it is I will write now. This is the divisor. We wrote it here. Quotient is 1 plus remainder 20. Next, bring this 50 here. 5050 is equals to. Bring this 20 here. 20 into. Now these two you do division. 20 and 50. I am dividing 50 by 20. 22s are 40. Remainder is 10. So this is the divisor. We wrote it here. And this is the quotient. So 20 into 2 plus remainder is 10. Next, bring 20 here is equals to this 10 here into. 10 2s are 20 plus 0 remainder. So whenever we got the remainder 0, we need to stop the process and this will become the HCF. So HCF of the 50 and 70 is 10. Let us check one more number, 25 and 36. So bigger number is A. 36 is equals to 25 into 1 plus 11 is the remainder. Next, bring 25 here is equals to 11 into 11 2s are 22 plus 3 remainder. Bring 11 here and the 3 here. 3 3s are 9 plus 2 remainder. Again, bring 3 here and 2. 2 1s are 2 plus 1 remainder. 2 is equals to 1 2 is 2 plus 0 remainder. So whenever we got the 0 remainder, we need to stop that and this will become the HCF. So HCF of the given two numbers is 1. Let us take one more question. Till now we did HCF by Euclid division process. Now we need to solve the same HCF and LCM by prime factorization. So first write the prime factors of 50. 50 can be written as, otherwise we will do some rough work here. 50. 5 10s are 5 2s are. So here 5 is a prime number, 5 is a prime number and 2 is also a prime number. So 50 can be written as 5 into 5 into 2, nothing but 5 square into 2. Next, for 60. 60. 2 30s are 60. 2 15s are 30. 3 5s are 15. So this will become 2 square into 3 into 5. So to find the HCF, we need to check the number which is common in both. Check it here. 2 is common as well as 5 also common. But 3 is not common. So 3 won't come in the HCF. So out of this 5 square and 5, which will be the smaller, that only we need to take for HCF. 5 square and 5. 5 is the smaller. So 5 into 2 and 2 square. 2 is the smaller. So 5 2s are 10. HCF of 50 and 60 is 10. Next, what about LCM then? For LCM, first check the common numbers. 5 square and 5 2 and 2 square. So in this you need to go with the greater number. 5 square and 5, the greater number is 5 square into 2 in and 2 square, the greater number is 2 square into. After finishing the common numbers, you need to write the extra numbers also. Here one more extra number 3 is there, so write that 3 also. 5 square 25, 2 square 4 into 3. 25 4 is 100, 100 3 is 300. So LCM of the given two numbers is 300. Okay, let's check one more question. Same HCF and LCM of 6 comma 9 by prime factorization. So 6 is equals to 2 into 3. 9 is equals to 3 into 3. Otherwise 3 square. So if we write the HCF, first we need to go the common. Here 3 is there, here also 3 is there. But smaller, 3 is smaller or 3 square is smaller? 3 is smaller. So HCF is 3. Next, LCM. First check the common. 3 and 3 square both are common. So in this greater one, 3 square is the greater. Into what is the extra number we have? 2 is extra. 3 square 9, 9 into 2, 18 is the LCM. Let's take one more question. This is one of the important questions. So the question asks like this. Is it possible for having any n value so that the last digit is 0? And here the same one more question. Always, what is the last digit of some 6 power 1 or 6 power 10 or 6 power 100 or 6 power 1000 or even 6 power n? So we need to understand the difference between these two questions clearly. The first question is, what is the n value so that the 6 power n with end with the last digit 0? And the second type of question is, what is the last digit for 6 power n? It may be 6 power 3 or 6 power 4 or whatever it may be. First, let us check with this question now. Any number, if it needs to be end with the digit 0, it should have 2 and 5 as the prime factors. So let us check once. 6 power n, if we write it as 2, 3 is 6 whole power n. So as we know, any number to be end with the digit 0, it should have 2 as well as 5 as the factors. Here if we check the factors of 6, 2 is a factor, okay, no problem. But 5 is not a factor. So it never end with the digit 0. It won't end with digit 0. It won't end up with the digit 0. Next, what is the last digit of 6 power n? 6 power 1 is a 6. 6 square 36. 6 cube 216. It continues like that only. So if you observe the last digits, always it ends with the digit 6. So 6 power n also, the last digit is always 6. Okay, let's look at one more question. Explain why the given numbers are composite numbers. 7 into 11 into 13 plus 13. If you observe this, this is total single term and this is the second term. In these two terms, we have a number common, that is 13. So if you take out 13 common, we remains with 7 into 11. 13 already we removed plus 1. So 13 into 7 into 11, 77 plus 1. 13 into 77 plus 1, 78. So here the given number can be able to written as a product of other numbers. So it is a composite number. So let us check one more then. This total is a single term. This total is single term. So in these two terms, we have some numbers common, that is 17 into 11, 17 into 11. So if we take out 17 into 11 common, remains with 2 plus 5. 17 into 11 into 2 plus 5, 7. Again, here also same. The given number can be written as product of some other number. So this is a composite number. Let us take one more question. Okay, let's look at the next topic. They'll ask the questions. Check whether the given rational number is a terminating or non-terminating repeating. If it is a terminating, then find the decimal. Let us check the first one. If we take this 3 by 8, this 3 by 8 can be written as 2 cube. Here the denominator, 8 can be written as 2 cube. In this type of questions, we don't have any work with the numerator, except in some conditions. That type of question also we will discuss one. So here, if the denominator is in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m, if the denominator is in the form of 2 power n into 5 power m, then we can say that the type of fraction or rational number is terminating. So it means in the denominator only we should have 2 power something, or else only 5 power something, or else 2 and 5 both together. Now let us check where we will use the numerator then. We have one question like this, 13 by 26. 13 by 26 can be written as 2 into 13. In this case, cancellation is possible. So here we are using the numerator, 1 by 2 again. So the denominator having 2. So this is also terminating decimal. Next, 2 by 7. Here the denominator 7. We cannot write that as a power of 2 or else power of 5 or else 2 into 5. So this is non-terminating repeating. Here 1 by 6. 6 can be written as 2 into 3. Here 2 is there, okay, no problem. But 3 is extra number. So this is also non-terminating repeating type of decimal. So to find the decimals for these two, compulsory we need to do division. Let us do division of second question. That is 2 by 7. So 0.0 here, 7 2s are 14, 6 carries, 7 8s are 56, so 4, 0 here, 7, 5 is 35, 5 remainder 0, 7, 7 is 49, 1 remainder 0, 7, 1 is 7, 3, 0, again 7, 4 is 28, 2, it can continue, so 0.285714, it continues still, so non-terminating, repeating. Then what about this 3 by 8, let us check once, 3 by 8 can be written as 2 cube. Here 2 cube is there, so you multiply and divide by 5 cube. If it is here 2 square, you multiply and divide by 5 square. Here it is only 2, you multiply and divide by 5. If it is 5 cube, you divide and multiply by 2 cube. 3 into 5 cube 125 by 2 cube into 5 cube 10 cube 125 into 3 3 5 is 15 5 1 3 2 6 7 3 1 375 by 10 cube 1000 375 by 1000 0.375. So this is one of the important questions. Okay, let's look at one more question. Show that root 2 is irrational number. So what we will take this, we will go with the contrary method or else contradiction. On the contrary, let us assume that root 2 is rational number. So if root 2 is rational number, that can be written in the form of a by b, where a comma b are integers and coprimes and b not equals to 0. So on the contrary, let us assume that root 2 is rational. If it is a rational number, we can able to write that in the form of a by b. So where a comma b are integers and coprimes, where b is not equals to 0. Now squaring on both the sides, root 2 whole square is equals to a by b whole square. Here square root and square will get cancelled, so we remains with 2 is equals to a square by b square. Take b square to the left side, we remains with 2b square is equals to a square. So this is equation 1. Now bring to this side, b square is equals to a square by 2. So from this we can conclude 2 divides a square. 2 divides a square. If 2 divides a square, 2 divides a also. So 2 divides a. 2 divides a. How we will write that one? A by 2. So 2 divides a. If 2 divides a, it will give some answer. So that is some constant c. Now take 2 to the right side. So we will get a is equals to 2c. So a is equals to 2c. This is equation number 2. So now substituting equation 2 in equation 1. What is equation 1? 2b square is equals to a square. So here in the place of a, we are substituting this value. 2b square equals to a value, how much? 2c whole square. 2b square is equals to 2c whole square, 4c square. 2 ones are, 2 twos are. So what we'll get here? B square is equals to 2c square. If you bring 2 this side, b square by 2 is equals to 2 square. Here b square by 2 is nothing but 2 divides b square. If 2 divides b square, 2 divides b also. So from these two conditions we can conclude 2 divides a as well as 2 divides b. 2 divides a and b, but it contradicts the fact that a comma b are coprimes. So root 2 is an irrational number. Okay, let's have a look at one more question. Show that 1 by root 2 is irrational number. Again same, on the contrary, let us assume 1 by root 2 is rational number. So 1 by root 2 can be written as a by b, where a and b both are integers, coprimes, and b not equals to 0. Now total equation I will reciprocate. 1 by root 2 will become root 2 by 1, which is equals to a by b will become b by a. Already we said the condition a comma b both are integers, so this value will be rational number. Root 2, in the previous problem we solved, it is irrational number. Irrational number is equals to rational number, it is impossible. This contradiction has arisen due to our wrong assumption. So 1 by root 2 is irrational. Next, 6 plus root 2 is there. Same, on the contrary, let us assume 6 plus root 2 is rational. So 6 plus root 2 can be written as a by b, where a comma b are integers and coprimes, and b not equals to 0. Take 6 that side, root 2 is equals to a by b, this plus 6 will become minus 6. A minus b into 6, 6b by b, that is equals to root 2. Here a, b all are integers, so this total RHS will become rational number, but this LHS is irrational. Rational is equals to irrational, this is wrong. So this contradiction has arisen due to our wrong assumption. So 6 plus root 2 is an irrational number. Let us check one more question. So did you observe the previous questions once? If the question is only root 2, you need to do squaring on both sides. 1 by root 2, no squaring is required. 6 plus root 2, no squaring is required. Root 3 plus root 5, where both the terms are irrational, in this case also squaring is compulsory. So again same, on the contrary, let us assume that root 3 plus root 5 is rational, so it can be written as a by b. Squaring on both the sides, root 3 plus root 5 whole square is equals to a by b whole square. Root 3 plus root 5 whole square, that is a square plus b square plus 2ab is equals to a square by b square. 3 plus 5, 8, plus 2 root 15 is equals to a square by b square. Take 8 to the right side, 2 root 15 is equals to a square by b square minus 8. 2 root 15 is equals to a square minus 8b square by b square. Take 2 also to the right side. So we will get root 15 is equals to a square minus 8b square divided by 2b square. Here same, a and b both are integers, so this RHS will become a rational number, but LHS is irrational number. Irrational is equals to rational, no, it is not possible. This contradiction has arisen due to our wrong assumption. So root 3 plus root 5 is irrational number. Now let us move to the logarithms. Very easy topic. So log 4 can be written as 2 square base 2 as it is. Now the same here also, log 2 as it is, base. 4 can be written as 2 square. If the power is for the number, write that as it is in the front. If the power is for the base, write the reciprocal. Here the power is for the number, so write that number as it is, that is 2 log 2 base 2. Here the power is for the base, so write the reciprocal. Reciprocal of 2, 1 by 2 log 2 base 2. Here log 2 base 2 value is 1, so 2 into 1. Here also log 2 base 2 value is 1, so 1 by 2 into 1. 2 into 1, 2, 1 by 2 into 1, 1 by 2. Log 1, log 1, whatever it may be the base, always the log 1 value is 0. Log 0, whatever it may be the base, log 0 is always not defined. Okay, let's look at one more question. Write the given as single logarithm. Already we know some formulas. Log a power m is equals to m into log a. If the power is there for the number, it will come to the front as it is. So in case if the number is there in the beginning, we can take that as the power. So let us apply this formula here. This is in the form of m into log a. So m into log a is nothing but log a power m. So the front number will go as the power. Front number will go as the power. So we will get log 3 power 2 plus log 5 power 3 minus log 2 power 5. Log 3 square 9 plus log 5 cube 125 minus log 2 power 5 32. Next, log a plus log b. What is the formula for this? Log a into b. So this is also same in the form of log a plus log b. So log 9 plus log 125 can be written as log 9 into 125 minus log 32. What is the formula for this now? Log a minus log b is equals to log a by b. So log 9 into 125 minus log 32 can be written as log 9 into 125 by 32. Log 9 into 125, 9 5 is 45, 5 4, 9 2 is 18, 22 2 2, 9 11 25 by 32. So the given question completely we need to write as a single logarithm. So the final answer is log 1125 by 32. Thank you, everyone.